Ladies and gentlemen, I apologise. We seem to have a bit of a seating issue here. I'd invite you to sit down until we can get it sorted, and then we'll ask you to stand again. Thank you for your patience. Stand back up now, that would be great. Thank you very much for your patience. Thank you.
Please be seated. Inga mana, inga reo, inga hoi fa, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, University staff, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council members and staff of the University. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will confer diplomas and award degrees in the Faculty of Education and Social Work. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we are very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated that the lifetime benefits of earning a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million. Your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Education and Social Work, we have seen several notable achievements in the last year. Dr. Eleanor Hoare won a National Tertiary Teaching Excellence Award. Dr. Ray C. Alata was the recipient of the 2015 New Zealand Association for Research and Education Awards for Excellence in Educational Research. Associate Professor Bev France and Dr. Kerry Lee won Technology Education Research Awards for their contribution to technology education, research and teaching. And Professor Stephen May was elected a fellow of the prestigious American Educational Research Association. In order to ensure that we continue to achieve successes like these and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, the university must do three things, in my view. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, I believe we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing is illustrated by the achievements I described earlier. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. It's no coincidence that in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, the University of Auckland came top in New Zealand in 35 of the 40 ranked, and we don't even teach two of them. If we just think about that for a moment, of the 40 ranked subjects, we teach 38 and we're ranked top in 35. It sounds like an outstanding result to me. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program so as to ensure that we do provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with the first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for all of us as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, it's the largest too, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. But today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I'm delighted to welcome our guest speaker, Ant Backhouse, who set up and runs the first New Zealand program of the I Have a Dream Charitable Trust, mentoring and tutoring mainly young Pacifica people from Mount Roskill. The goal is to help them into university education or meaningful careers. Now, 12 years on, his dreamers have exceeded national NCEA benchmarks and university entrance results. Around 80% of them have entered post-secondary education, compared with only 30% of their peers from the same primary school, and many continue in diploma and degree level study. Ant has a 25-year history working with and leading young people. He established his own Urban Hope Charitable Trust, helping underprivileged young people in the late 90s. He was a founding trustee on the Akahiki Trust Board for digital enablement of low decile students and has served on primary school boards of trustees. Among his awards and achievement, Ant received the Mount Roskill Pukitipapa Council Youth Award in 2010 and 2 years later was recognised with a Tour of Duty Award by the I Have a Dream Foundation in New York for his total commitment to his dreamers. He received a Queen's Service Medal for his service to youth and education in the 2014 Queen's Birthday Honours List. Ant is pushing ahead to extend the work of I Have a Dream so that more New Zealand children can benefit from his 12 years of research and groundbreaking work. Among his current activities, he's leading the Trust launch of a new initiative to inspire the dreams of around 1,500 children in low-decile schooling communities in Whangarei. Ladies and gentlemen, please join with me in welcoming Ant.
Kia ora, kia rana, talofa lava, malola le, pakalofa lahi atu, bula vanaka, namaste, and greetings to you all. As you've heard, my name's Ant Backhouse, and I'm the CEO for the I Have a Dream Charitable Trust. But before I jump into my speech, first of all, I want to acknowledge the tremendous effort you've all put in today to pursue a tertiary education. Congratulations. Secondly, what an honour and a bit of a surprise it was to be invited to speak to you all today. A surprise because most of you have all got one up on me. Level 6 on the NZQA framework was the highest level of that my intelligence ever got to. So I had to wonder, did someone forget to do their research when inviting me to speak to you? Turning to the internet, I decided to do my own research. Typing in Anthony, I came across a site called Urban Dictionary, and aha, therein lie the answers to why I appear before you today. Anthony, super sexy and gorgeous with a smile that will make you melt and a body to die for. He is funny, charming, and is absolutely amazing in bed. No lies, you can look it up if you like, 800 thumbs up. Probably all by people called Anthony. Let's just say that given you teachers and social workers are the hope of educating and supporting our next generation of children and young people, that I do hope you got your qualifications using better websites than Urban Dictionary. Despite what the internet says about me, I'm glad to report that I kind of do have a bit of a PhD in life, but I'm always dreaming of the day that the University of Auckland decide just to give me an honorary degree, and that dream is getting closer every day because, as you can see, I'm literally now only about 5 steps away from it. Hint, hint, Graham. So today, as I'm speaking to you, I want you to hold 2 images in your mind, a microscope and a telescope. Oh, that's right. You guys are education and social work students, eh? Do you guys know what those are? Oh, sorry, that was a bit mean. Good. Okay, so now I want you to cast your minds back to the day that you took your first steps as a child and began to walk. Some of you may struggle to remember, but I know many of your family up there today, surrounding you here, will. That was a microscope moment. The world was looking down on you and magnifying your achievement and celebrating your first steps. Now let's fast forward a little to the first day of starting school. Another microscope moment, but also a telescope one. Because your parents and whānau looked out to the horizons and imagined that one day you might finish school, go to university, and achieve the dream of a tertiary degree. Now here you are. As a result of your hard work, you've reached the end of the telescope moment and are graduating. But I'm sorry to say your parents told you a little white lie. Because today isn't really the telescope moment. It's just another microscope moment. Now, don't get me wrong. It's great that you're here and we're magnifying it and celebrating it, but the true pinnacle of your success, the true telescope moment, will be defined by you now looking up and looking out to the big wide world and applying your learning to the world. Yes, the true measure of success is not in what we know, but in how we go about doing the things with what we know, and the values and motives that we carry with us in the doing. Now, I can tell that you're already off to a bit of a wrong start with your motives here because you chose to line your pockets with the gold by choosing education and social work. Yeah, right. That would make a good 2 easy ad, wouldn't it? But there is some good news here for education and social work students. My generation has come up with brilliant ideas. Computers, the internet, social media to depersonalise human touch, new technologies that are taking over our lives, creating new social pressures, robots that are taking over people's jobs, a love for material junk that is placing huge pressures on our environment, processing plants which create food at the push of a button contributing to our health problems, buzzing cities that never sleep, the result, broken families, mental health issues, increased poverty, and environmental challenges like never before. Yes, that's right. My generation has created some of the world's wicked problems, and now we're reliant on you to fix them. There are two things that will see this world come to an end rather quickly, and that is if we don't look after our people or our planet. Education and social work consumes itself with taking care of both those things. So today I challenge you to lift up your head, to look through the telescope at the big wide world and ask yourself, what is it that I'm going to do with all this learning, and what is it that I want to be defined by? What really is my telescope moment? 25 years ago, I did this just that. Having left school to pursue a corporate career, I worked my way into management and was climbing the corporate ladder. I got married, bought my first house, was earning a decent pay, living the Kiwi dream. I was important and successful in the eyes of the world, but was I happy? No. When I looked through the telescope, what did I see? Life was all about me, 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 and my empire. So in the late 90s, I decided to shift my telescope to focus on a different horizon. I decided to make helping others my future. My wife and I gave up our corporate careers. We became posties on bikes, delivering mail just to put food on the table. We could be finished by lunchtime, and then we spent all afternoon in the low decile community of Wesley Mount Roskill running programs that helped young people succeed in their education and life. Then in 2002, as though it was meant to be, I met Scott Gilmore, a philanthropist who was keen to start the I Have a Dream program in New Zealand, and he was keen to employ me to run it. So in 2003, I began with a group of 53 students as 8-year-olds in Decile 1 Wesley Primary School, and for the next 12 years, I grew up with them, helped them navigate the system, believed in them, advocated for them, ensured they had the networks, the resources, the people surrounding them to succeed, and the rest is history. Those kids are all now 21. And 80% of them went on to tertiary education after high school, compared to only 30% of the kids in the year level above from the same primary school. In 2014, the Queen and Governor General decided I should get a Queen's Service Medal for my services to youth and education, but for me, that wasn't the real pinnacle of success. The real pinnacle of success was that these kids now look at me as their white daddy, a significant adult in their lives, and I look at them as my dreamers. Our journey together is entwined. I helped change their life, but in doing so, they changed mine. So today, you have an opportunity to look up from this microscope moment, set your telescope on your own horizon, and go out and make a difference with every life you touch. But in closing, I encourage you to carry with you five values. Five values that every person I employ to work alongside the hundreds of kids our organisation now is working with upholds. Values our research show that every young person needs in order to succeed. Tumanako, meaning hope and aspiration. Young people need to be given something to hope for. Whanaunatanga, meaning relationship. Young people need significant adults that come alongside them, truly believe in them, and push them towards those dreams. Ako, meaning two-way learning. Young people need lifelong learners, adults that can teach them about this world, but also adults that are willing to learn about and value their world. Rangatiratanga, meaning self-determination. Young people need adults that help grow their identity and develop their wings to fly. Aroha, meaning love. Young people need to be loved unconditionally. Before they read your whiteboard, they will read your heart. Go forth and prosper. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Thank you, Anne, for an entertaining but challenging address. Can you all join with me in showing your appreciation? This is a meeting of Council in convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees upon those who within the Faculty of Education and Social Work have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education and Social Work, Professor Aitken, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Education and Social Work. Graduate Diploma in Education, Eliza Joan Sager. Graduate Diploma in Teaching, Early Childhood Education, Melanie Ray Anderson. Laura Elise Bennett. Tabitha Jane Coulthis. Robin Lucille Cross. Kai Ding. Suchitra Dutta. Tania Rosanna Utzig. Davanya Rochelle Forbes. Talia Brown Goodger. Ashley Storm Hewitt. Kahurangi te oki ngā meremere hohepa. An Cheng Hu. Peter Bruges Jarvis. Vidraswi Jefferson Stewart Jirairaj. Danielle Louise Kennedy. Saruchi Kucha. Audrey Lee. Kelly Marie Lewis. Guangjing Liu. Zhu Liu. Kimberly Jane Lorney. Michael Richard Loretz. Selena Lai. Hayley Jacqueline McDonald. Claire Louise McMeeking. Linda Gibson McIre. Sophie Fitzpatrick Moskowitz. Josephine Sojing Foon. Olivia Zoe Santo. Miriam Syed Sheikh. Crystal Maria Shields. Wen Song. Sonia Devi Steinmetz. Annalise Stusner. Jody Isabel Templeman. Dukalupe Vahi. Eva Marie Walker. Charlotte Victoria White. Mo Young. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Primary, Ryan Wendon Abbott. Paige Renee Adams. Lavina Laura Lintonia Akaola. Amy Alexander. Christopher James Bailey. Lucy Elizabeth Barker. Lauren Nicole Bell. Paige Kirsten Blackett. Frances Jane Britz. Kate Louise Brown. Christopher Robert Patrick Buchan. Catherine Corning Butterfield. Candice Marie Cassie. Ching Yu Chan. Albertian Maria Chignall. Emma Violet Christensen. Nicola Jane Corsa. Sarah Robin Daniel. Bodhika Priya Dashana Da Silva. Bernadette Chiwing Devereaux. Dublina Day. Amanda Jane Dove. Melissa Jane Draffin. Perpetual Susanna Da Silva. Victoria Susan Earle. Juliana Bing Wang U. Deborah Lee Farmer. Megan Laura Fisher. Donald Gordon Forbes. Jessica Trudy Grinlinton. Karen K. Hammond. Adam Francis Graham Hand. Janelle Ruth Harris. Juliet Kate Hawksworth. Bradley Charles Healy. Carolyn Suzanne Heathorn. Gina Hell. Emily Rachel Howth. Paige Alexa Jackson Smith. Achana Kave. Jean Young Kim. Min Song Kim. Rachel Catherine Lang. Heath Muir Nicole Lucy. Claire Chia-Wen Lin. Zoe Marie Loretz. Riven Main Lundovic. Carl Douglas Maskell. Claire Marie McCurran. Elizabeth Ruth McLaughlin. Alina Kim McMillan. Nathan Amos Metzger. Katie Louise Miller. Otali Gwendolyn Louise Morrison. Anwar Hussein Nadar. Narendra Naidu. Marjan Nelson. Hyo Mung Park. Lucina Hayam Park. Ashira Aalia Pashotam. Luan Tigan Puihipi. Rebecca Margaret O'Hanlon. Molavia Pulapuna. Liam Peter Marshall Raven. Avril Elaine Reed. Disha Utkarsh Sanjanwala. Benjamin Ivan Shrimpton. Natalie Sarchiku Snook. Shannon Barbara Swainston. Hannah Elizabeth Swan. Elena Talimahina McDonald. Jamie Lee Thompson. Melanie Jane Pongiavalu. Meliane Valu. Hannah Margaret West. Luke Thomas Whitley. Caitlin Elizabeth Williams. Natasha Louise Williams. Andrew John Wright. Monica Rose Yeoman. Bachelor of Education Teaching. Erica Louise Adkins. Lauren Ione Afoa. Dominica R. Lamb. Rianne Louise Aitken. Letitia Yvonne Taylor Akulu. Julianne Carol Allen. Margarita Antonio. Danielle Terry Ann Atwood. Umundi Ko Ojila. Cedric Daniel Babu. Lauren Karen Bailey. Brittany May Barr. Michael James Barry. Regan Elizabeth Baxter. Sapphire Leal Bedgegood. Liana Okihanga Katarina Bia. Susan Jane Bennett. Donna Marie Bird. Rebecca May Bauman. Matthew Lawrence Brackey. Mackenzie Patricia Bramwell. Zana Monique Brissick. Kitty Lucy Broughton. Sarah Elizabeth Bush. Hayoung Kai. Tanya Ann Cartman. Atama Marua Toa Cassidy. Ashley Corin Chalice. Shivani Swetha Chand. Ina Choi. Senior Scholar in Education, Catherine Sophia Chung. Anne-Marie Clauston. Frances Janet Cornwall. Bridget Rose Darcy Crawshaw Crawshaw McLean. Evan James Crean. Rose Elizabeth Curran Brown. Sumia Ibrahim Dadi Patel. Sharman Davids. William Levi Dean. Fiona Marie Dixon. Julie Christine Dowman. Katrina Nikki Earle. Samantha Louise Ethel. Christina Charis Fa'ato'ato Akia. Crystal Lonatina Fanga. Gloria Aileni Ngatokoroa Fepuleai. Michelle Louise Fogart. Ella Sydney Fogart. Rebecca Helen Frost. Rita Susan Furivai. Doris Gia. Michael Llewellyn Glynn. Siboniso Cynthia Gona. Divya Rani Ganda. Erica Blanche Gracias. Katie Grace Grant. Annette Carolyn Grayson. Cheryl Joyce Haynes. Sapphire Maria Hall. Justine Nicole Hamilton. Tufosa Hanipale. Caitlin Hannah Harris. Vanessa Marie Harvey. Vaisenia Lohangale Fuluuhula I Bedeli Haunga. Gillian Marie Hayward. Stacey Erin Afina Henderson. Elizabeth Mary Hewlett. Tessa Morgan Hodder. Susanna Kate Holliday. Bonnie Patricia Holmes. Ruth Teresa Holt. Amy Hope Hopping. Hannah May Horo Gregory. Anita Joy Horsley. Carolyn Elizabeth Hoyles. Mystery Michelle Santina Flavel Hunter. Anna Madeline Hurst. Amy Faitiri Hutchinson. Emily Vera Ingor. Megan Elizabeth Jackson. Taryn Ann Jago. Madison Elizabeth James. Danelle Jamieson. Jasmine Suman Chi. Senior Scholar in Education, Nicola Michelle Johnson. Rita Mary Johnson. Morgan Laurel Johnston. Melissa Ann Jones. Melissa Margaret Jowett. Bianca Alexandra Jukes. Estelle Esme Julius. Karen Cam. Chelsea Ann Kane. Ruby Amelia Kay. Jessica Amy Kidd. Hyunji Kim. Nicole Catherine Knight. Katie Louise Kobilas. Sasha Rose Kulik. Nayin Kwan. Kate Louise Lawrence. Elizabeth Valentine Lau Pepe. Hayun Lee. Natalia Margareta Christine Lee. Michaela James Lill. Alan Rob Lennox. Chao Wen Lin. Anna Louis. Xia Yi Luo. Ma Tian Tan. Cheryl Angela McDonald. Kimberly Emma Macken. Wikitoria Patty Maguire. Leah Edany Mahi. Anna Marie Major. Kanisha Lisa Mellon. Claire Marie Elizabeth Mayo. Carol McDonald. Jessica Hinirangi May McGrath. Elizabeth Marion McMurdo. Tessa Louise McNichol. Muzima Meha. Victoria Kelly Alice Miller. Elizabeth Ann Millett. John Charles Morrell. Brogan Louise Morrison. Antonia Caitlin Moyle. Alicia Rose Much. Siriling Ashwani Mutia. Simone Eden Myberg. Arishma Anita Narayan. Priyanka Pooja Narayan. Senior Scholar in Education, Thomas Gary Norton. Gemma Louise O'Loughlin. Claire Elizabeth Owen. Beryl Ann Offspring. Alice Park. Hyang Park. Georgia Chloe Pascoe. Janie Louise Petroni. Chelsea Elizabeth Patton. Laura Grace Pearton. Camille Roimata Perenara.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Jane Son on piano will now perform Etude in A Minor by Friedrich Chopin. If you would like to hear more from our wonderful young musicians, I invite you to attend the Graduation Concerto Gala Competition to be held in the Town Hall on Thursday, 12 May at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Education and Social Work, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education and Social Work, Professor Aitken, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching, Christine Aroha Peters. Emmeline Robin Pickering Martin. Haley Louise Pipes. Julie Ruth Prendergast. Martha Joy Ta'aro Priest. Senior Scholar Education, Waina Matama Jane Pry. Olivia Esme Akakura Prowse. Alison Catherine Redfern Daly. Emma Thimungaru Rekareka. Kimberly May Rivett. Stephen Richard Douglas Ross. Joel Rowden. Shafia Aisha Saheed. Juliana Kaitinka Saini. Michaela Jean Samaele. Shane Angela Sharnick. Ashley Louise Skelhingelout. Natalia Dorotea Senesic. Mina Sharifi. Young Sir Shin. Linda Sifamoka Sifahione. Brosnan Kane Anthony Dennis Bingay Siluunga. Natalie Simi. Abby Jane Skeen. Brooke Leslie Rita Smith. Kelly Ngari Smith. Lauren Louise Spencer. Adeline Michelle Vicky Staunton. Woo! Senior Scholar in Education, Danielle Lucy Stone. Jing Sun. China Yvonne Swan. Kayla Swift. Naomi Kathleen Tutini Tamangaro. Talalele Tanielu. Sharisi Te Aroha Waherere Te Ua. Alison Geraldine Teasdale. Rosalina Faye Tenari. Annabelle Alicia Thorne. Katia Rose Michelle Timu. Sophia Nuno Alofa La Ata Ata Tipi. Moira Atepera Tupo Manu Tafia Maalili. Natasha Christina Unkovich. Manuel Margaret Vahakula. Tali Malama Marina Tofa Vaisal Halasan. Angel May Virko. Shalom Vili. Elise Hannah Voskizang. Megan Ann Walker. Sarah Marie Ward. Stephen Philip Matthew Warden. Samantha Paris Weir. Jenna Jean West. James Michael Wheaton. Dylan Brian Wiggle. Yvette Huili Wong. Gabrielle Barbara Wooderson. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work, Asia Howard Birmingham. Asta Lee Crawford. Alison Edmonds. Lisa Joy Fa'afo. Claire Arima Flula. Jessica Palipafanote. Josephine Ada Husband. Waimatangi Iosefa. Senior Scholar in Education, Bronwyn Ann Lewis. Melissa Sarah Magalong. Rochelle Venetia Malatino. Kerry Louise McVicker. Brenna Patricia Jane Melhush. Riala Paraiti Newman. Colleen Joy O'Brien. Heather Carmen Ogle. Rupal Hashadri Patel. Joanne Sialefapati. Nicole Renata. Agnes Grace Simpson. Shay Salilo Talamaival. Faake Alele Telefone. Christy Elizabeth Tennant. Rachel Bianca Tongatama. Palamurugan Bankata Chalam. Jaji Connie Chu, Connie Yu. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Distinction. Antonia Jane Beckett in Literacy Education. Julia Amy Brackey in Literacy Education. Bronwyn Ann Fennessy in Literacy Education. Margarita Teresa Gray. Keshni Lata Kumar. Sarah Jane Martin in Literacy Education. Shelley Patricia Mustin. Christopher John Niles. Ruwen Jung. Postgraduate Diploma in Education with Merit, Li Yan He. Dawn Kathleen Tafford. Postgraduate Diploma in Education, Lawrence Allen Akwe. Luvis Hanadije Shandane Jailani Vodando. Aruna Krishna. Tarongapai, o te hahi ratana morehu. daughter. Michelle Shweta Prasad in Literacy Education. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision with Distinction, Antoinette Luxton. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision with Merit, Jane Greaves Kay. Postgraduate Diploma in Professional Supervision, Junipa Fatafehi Unga Alupe V. Postgraduate Diploma in Teaching Secondary Field-Based, Susan Berry. Christian Horatiu Kuchuzan. Carla Fiona Dunn. Helen Francis Embleton. Jane Louise Ferguson. Rikihana Rose Gernick. Lauren Rose Jessup. Louisa Jackie Teafina King. Jason Sharma. William James Lasala Watling. Sarah Jane Watt. Jonathan David Wieland. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with First Class Honours, Caleb Joel Allison. Karen Marie Belt. Dawn Chi Chen. Alexandra Louise Chester. Matthew Joseph Massey Goodwin. Sang Hee Han. Amy Jane Harris. Briar Chu Lei Lister. Nasesha Mohan. Gina May Young. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Rowan Brendan King. Lucan Lowe. Sasha Emily Morn. Stephanie Ann Parker. Nicole Joanna Tuinu Koafea. To the degree of Bachelor of Education Teaching Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Cheryl Ann Snellett. Woo! to the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with First Class Honours, Jessica Susanna Booth. Jade Lee George. Zoe Zane Hicks. Kirsty Louise Middleton. Hayley Michelle Thomas. To the degree of Bachelor of Social Work Honours with Second Class Honours First Division, Rosanna Marie Hamilton. Hyo Jung Lee. Mandali Smuts. To the degree of Master of Education with First Class Honours, Jean Maria Allen. Vanita May Easton. Sharon Donella Fuimana. Devika Neelam Tag. Ji Hong Chung. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours First Division, Angela Dawn Cave. Horsey Boone. Sandra K. Joseph. Justine Roimata Irena Kingi. Paula Jane Miller. Lucinda Mary Murch. Jung Chow. To the degree of Master of Education with Second Class Honours Second Division, Gillian Ruth Lalesi. Chanel Tareda Kohuska. To the degree of Master of Education, Ruth Louise Round. To the degree of Master of Social Work with First Class Honours, Paula Ann Mary Neth. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with First Class Honours, Alexandria Gabrielle Bradley. Julie Elizabeth Carter. Megan Catherine Ellen Clark. Jasdeep Kaur. Hayden John McLeod. Jayshree Anita Mora. Nathan Robert Nee. Ellie Joseph Parker. Anna Beatrice Tizard. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with Second Class Honours, First Division, Julia Moyer Burden. Jie Chen. Ning Ding. Olivia Emily James. Laura Kate Roberts. To the degree of Master of Social Work Professional with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Benny Jacob. Gilza Maria Lacerda Owobukiti. Mira Jamesh Weiss. To the degree of Master of Teaching Primary with Second Class Honours, First Division, Miriam Ruth Giles. Leanne Faye Leckie. To the degree of Master of Teaching Primary with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Tuako Thieu.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Education, Francine Yvonne Bennett. Francine investigated the succession planning practices that faith-based integrated schools in New Zealand use to build leadership capacity and ensure continuity of vision, culture, and special character. A purposely designed framework highlighted which practices enabled these schools to be well prepared for principal succession. The findings show the importance of schools implementing succession planning practices in preparation for principal change whenever that may occur in the future. Congratulations, Francine. Deanna Marie Johnston. Deanna's research contributed to a critical understanding of the place and purpose of key competencies in the New Zealand curriculum, with the voices of primary school children central to the work. The findings highlight issues such as extreme individualism and competition, and their impact on social collective education ideals, such as community and cooperation in curriculum and education. Deanna. Marianne McCullum in Education. Sorry, to the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, my apologies. Marianne McCullum in Education. Marianne's study examined the experiences of young bisexual women as they negotiated their bisexual identities at secondary schools in New Zealand. The research reveals participants' experiences of bi-misogyny and ways their bisexuality was misrecognised and erased within the context of school culture and curriculum-based sexuality education. It also offers strategies and recommendations made by participants for meeting the schooling needs of young bisexual women. Marianne, congratulations. Adrian Owen Schoon in Education. Adrian's research explored how alternative education tutors re-engage some of New Zealand's most disenfranchised students in learning. Using poetic inquiry, he created 200 poems from tutors' words and experiences, which he synthesised and visually represented as 21 constellations of tutor essences. His work navigates our return to ancient notions of holistic teaching, while also offering us an artful research methodology. Adrian, congratulations. Rachel Allison Williams in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. In her thesis, Rachel drew on positive youth development and health promotion theory to explore mechanisms for improving the social competence of students attending low decile schools in New Zealand. Rachel's findings contribute importantly to our understanding of the mechanisms associated with program effectiveness, and in particular, the impact school transience has on the social competence of children attending high transient schools in low decile communities. Rachel. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Education and Social Work.
Teaching Excellence Awards. The university places considerable significance on excellence in teaching. It recognises this by making awards each year to teachers who have demonstrated excellence in aspects of teaching. These awards are contestable across the university and signify a truly superior achievement. An award for excellence in postgraduate research supervision has been made to Professor Judy Parr in the School of Curriculum and Pedagogy within the Faculty of Education and Social Work. I call upon a student of that faculty, Kath Glasswell, to read the citation for Professor Parr. Should just note that Kath Glasswell has come all the way from California to make this citation.
I am so proud to be here today because the university is honouring an outstanding teacher and scholar. Professor Judy Parr has been my teacher and mentor for nearly 25 years. That's a long time. A few years ago, I asked her why she'd agreed to supervise my PhD when it seemed to me, looking back now, that I had such a lot to learn and I was going to be a fairly intensive teaching job for her. Judy replied, "I could see a spark in you. The seeing of sparks, the lighting of fires, and the fanning of the flames of learning and intellectual independence are themes common to the ways in which Judy's past and present students talk about their experiences with her. In a teaching career that has lasted 4 decades, I did say that, 4 decades, Professor Judy Parr has systematically supported generations of students to achieve their personal bests. Here at the University of Auckland, she has walked the long and arduous path to achieving greatness with dozens of PhD and master's students, many of whom have received awards for research excellence. Judy's teaching isn't just about the getting of degrees or awards, though. Her work is central to the development of new generations of educational researchers and scholars. Her impact extends across the educational systems of New Zealand and reaches out across the globe to other countries, including developing nations. The most inspiring aspect of Judy's work, well, of the work of any great teacher, is that it's driven by a passion for the learning of others and for the improvement of the self. It is this aspect of academic life that Judy finds most rewarding. It's a way she can pass on the fire of learning to others, and a vital way in which she can contribute to our understandings of how education systems work, how our teachers and children learn, and how we might make the very best of any opportunities to achieve justice in the world through quality education. Congratulations, Professor Parr, on a well-deserved award.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. Please. While you are standing, it's also a great time for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. Thank you. This concludes this meeting of Council in convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programme.